everyone, so today's video is going to be my 2012 absolute favourite products. I've got a few different products from each different category, so like lipstick, face products, mascara, blah blah blah, and I've tried to include a drugstore one and a high-end one so that if you can't afford the high-end one, at least you can try out the drugstore one. Now I'll start with lip products. Now this category is probably the hardest for me to like narrow down because there's so many lip products that I love, but I will try my best. So two of my favourite lipsticks come from Bobbi Brown and from MAC. The two from Bobbi Brown are the creamy lip colours in Pink Cloud and Caramel. So basically what I do with these two is I mix them together. You can wear them on their own, but I just find that the colour you get from mixing them is amazing. It's like a really nice baby pastel pink. Now the reason these are so amazing is because they just sit really, really nicely on the lips. If you are like me and you have lots of little lines and cracks in your lips and lipsticks can tend to like, you know, settle into them and look really gross and dry, these will never, ever, ever do that. They just are amazing. They're like a billion, billion times better than the Revlon lip butters. They've got so much pigment in them, but they feel like a lip balm. So very, very comfortable to wear as well. The other two lip products are from MAC. The first one is Coral Bliss. And the second one is, this one is a cream sheen and this one is a Sheen Supreme. And this one is in Got a Dash. They're pretty much the same colour. It's a very, very slight difference. I love these for the same reasons as I love the Bobbi Brown ones. They're just really, really nice on the lips. They stay really, really nice and soft and creamy and smooth. And they don't settle into any of the, you know, lines on my lips and stuff like that. So those were the two high-end ones. Now the two drugstore ones that I love. Everyone watching this video, I'm guessing, will know my absolute favourite lipstick I've ever tried, ever, from any brand, any price, ever, is NYX Black Label Lipstick in Nude. If you've seen me wear nude lipsticks or you have like a nude lipstick on, it's probably like 9 times out of 10. This lipstick doesn't settle into the lines of my lips, smells like grapes, oh, so good. It's so creamy, so pigmented, so cheap. I just love it. It's, yeah, definitely my holy grail lipstick. Another one is an Australian product. It is Chi Chi Viva La Diva Lipstick in Blonde Ambition. It's another kind of corally one, but it's like a fluoro corally, pinky corally colour. Corally peachy colour. I just love it because I can wear it on its own and have like a really nice bright coral lipstick, or I can dull it down with a nude lipstick and make it into like a pastel coral peachy colour. A little bit more expensive, but it's worth it, I find. Now for blushes. So my favourite would have to be Jordana's Coral Sandy Beach, which I've had for ages but never got around to using until recently. It's just a really, really nice corally pink. That's pretty much it. It lasts all day, the colour's really nice, doesn't fade too much. It's really, really cheap, so that's pretty much why I love it. The next one is from The Balm. I'm not sure if you consider that brand drugstore or not, but oh well. And it is in Frat Boy. This is just a really, really nice pink. It's got, I don't know, it's kind of like a peachy pink, a soft pink. I'm really bad at explaining colours, but I just, yeah, I used to use this like 24/7. It's just a really, really nice blush, really nice texture. It's a huge pan, cute packaging, doesn't fade too much, looks really natural, and it's quite cheap, I think. So, yes. The next ones that I love would have to be from NARS. I am obsessed with, if I can find it, NARS Orgasm. It's pretty much a given. Most people would love this blush because it's just, you know, infamous. But it's a really nice peachy pink with gold shimmer. I also love NARS Gilda. I haven't gotten around to wearing this one as much, but I know that I do love it when I do wear it. A few other favourites of mine that I have recently bought that I know I will be wearing a lot more in the future are the MAC blushes. There is this one on the very left is a powder blush, this one's sheer tone, and this one is powder. This one's Melba, the one in the middle is peaches, and this one is flower power. I don't know how you pronounce that, but they're just really, really nice shades. Definitely very me kind of shades. I love my pinky peachy colors. And yes, that's pretty much it for blushes. I've been very obsessed with blushes recently, so that's why I have so many. Now time for my favourite highlighters. My all-time favourite highlighter is the NARS highlighter in Albatross. It is a very, very light yellow with gold shimmer. It's basically just gold, a gold highlighter. Absolutely amazing. It looks amazing with NARS Orgasm. It's a lot of gold shimmer, but it just looks awesome together. I also love the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Lightscapade. Just a really, really light, light highlighter. It's much more natural, you get much more of a natural finish from this if you don't really tend to wear highlighters very often, or you're not really sure how to use them or scared of using them, I don't know. This one's really, really nice and natural because it kind of fades a little bit, I found, so it doesn't look too full on, whereas the NARS one doesn't really fade at all. And I actually just tried to look for a drugstore highlighter, but I don't think I have one. I think I've gotten rid of them because I have so many high-end ones, so there you go. Now time for bronzers. Now, I've got three. These are the only three that I have. I've gotten rid of my other ones, and I can't narrow these ones down because they're all just amazing. They're all high-end ones. I'll start off with Hoola by Benefit. I recently started using this again and just fell in love with it all over again. I think, realistically, this would have to be my all-time favourite bronzer, even though I don't really use it as much as I should, considering it's my favourite. The colour is just awesome, the texture is awesome, it's just really nice on the face. I think I'm wearing it now. Am I wearing it today? I think I'm wearing it today, yep. The next favourite is Bobbi Brown Golden Light Bronzing Powder. This is just a great everyday standard bronzing powder. You can use it to warm up your neck, you can use it to contour, you can use it to, like, you know, bronze, add some warmth to your face. It's just really nice. It's a really nice natural colour, and I think it is actually quite similar to in colour to Hoola by Benefit. Last favourite would have to be NARS Laguna Bronzer. It's just a really, really nice bronzer. It's just it's just a nice bronzer. Pretty much the same reasons that I like the other ones. It just looks natural, nice colour, isn't too pink or warm toned, red base, whatever. It has a little bit of shimmer in it, but you can't tell once it's on your skin because it just is quite natural. My bun looks like a big poo on top of my head. Like an actual just big poo on my head. Anyway, my favourite face products. I'll start off with foundation. It would have to be MAC Pro Longwear. I'm not really sure why I decided that I love this one much more than my MAC Studio Fix, because I used to use Studio Fix all the time. I'm actually not too sure. I think I like the coverage a little bit better. I think I just like how it lasts longer on my skin. Doesn't let any shine through. It's pretty, like, you know, nice and full coverage. But again, so is Studio Fix. So I'm not sure why this one just gets my vote, but it does, so yes. And with these face products, I just realised that I'm not going to have a drugstore like counterpart, because I only use high-end makeup for my face, like face products, but that's okay. My favourite concealers would have to be Bobbi Brown Creamy Concealer. As you can see, this one has been very, very well loved, and I have another little backup when this one is all finished with. They are just amazing. They are so creamy, like very, very full coverage. They don't dry out on your skin. They look natural. They last long enough when you set them with a powder. I don't know, they're just really, really nice. And favorite corrector would obviously be Bobbi Brown correctors. They're just the bomb. Literally, there's no other, like, correctors that are as good as Bobbi Brown's correctors, so there you go. Now time for loose powders. So as you can see, I have got a lot of loose powders. I've got the MAC loose powder, I have Face of Australia loose powder, I've got the MAC Mineralize foundation, and I've got the Models Prefer Mineral foundation. So in terms of the best loose setting powder, yeah, the loose translucent setting powder would have to be the Face of Australia one in translucent loose powder, that's the name of it. So I am yet to find a powder that is as amazing as this one. It is translucent, but it does not go ashy on my skin or anything like that. It sets it, no shine comes through, unless it's like a really, really hot day, but that's, you know, hard to avoid. It's a huge amount of product inside it. It is 30 grams, whereas the MAC one is 8 grams. Holy crap, I actually did not even realize that. 30 grams compared to 8 grams. That is just a bit of an insult that I even bought this one. This is like $12 or something. This one was probably about 47 or 40 or something. So considering you're getting about 4 times the amount of product in here, but you're paying about 3 times as much to get this one, I think that was correct math, so I'm not sure. It just makes so much more sense to go with this one. Now time for favourite pressed powders. Favourite drugstore is Astralis's Fresh and Flawless Pressed Powder. Mine is in Darkest Brown. Oh my gosh, I have used these powders. This is another Astralis one, but it's just in the square container. It pretty much looks the exact same on the skin as the compact does, as the round one does. I have used these for years and years and years. They have a really good coverage, and it's pretty much the exact same coverage as MAC Studio Fix, which is my favourite drug, high-end one. Yeah, pretty much the exact same coverage. I actually like the colour of this one more than I do my Studio Fix. I got NW30 in my Studio Fix because NC30 was way too light, funnily enough. I just compare the amount of product in each one. The Astralis one is oil-free and fragrance-free. Well, that's good. But it has 12 grams, and the MAC one has 15 grams. So there you go, MAC actually has a little bit more in there, which is quite a nice surprise because you don't usually get that from high-end makeup. Now time for eyebrow products. Favourite drugstore eyebrow product, and the only eyebrow product that I use for my brows, is Jordana's Brow Eye Shadow Powder in 04 Brown. That's what I'm wearing my brows now. That's what I always wear my brows. And I just thought, if you use like a really heavy hand, you get a really dark colour. If you use a light hand, you get a lighter colour. So it kind of adjusts, I find, which I really, really, really like. And my favourite brow gel is the Essence Lash and Brow Clear Gel Mascara. This is just incredibly cheap and does the job. Just sets my brows in place and stops them from moving. Favourite mascara would have to be the Jordana Best Lash Extreme Volumizing Mascara. It's not waterproof, but it makes your lashes look really nice and big and voluminous. Voluminous, I hate that word. It's like $2 as well, so you can't go wrong with that one. Favourite gel eyeliner is absolutely, without a slight shadow of a doubt, the Essence Gel Eyeliner in Midnight in Paris. It's just a pure black. I have the MAC one and it is pretty crappy. It's like, I bought the black one and you have to like layer it on to get like an actual pure black. I have other brands as well, but that's not important. This one is just the absolute bomb. In terms of favourite high-end eyeliners, it would have to be the Bobbi Brown Longwear Gel Eyeliners. I have one in Twilight Night Shimmer Ink. They're just really, really, really nice, and because I work for Bobbi Brown, I use these all the time on customers, and they're just so smooth and creamy. They're kind of like the Essence one, but even still, I prefer the Essence ones. Favourite Kohl eyeliner would have to be the MAC Eye Kohl in Smolder. I always say that really, really weirdly. And then favourite drugstore eyeliner is Revlon Colorstay's eyeliner in, I think it's just, yeah, black. It's just like a retractable one. These are my go-to favourite eyeliners. Favourite primers or eyeshadow bases would have to be the, like, my absolute favourite would be MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. Absolutely amazing. I love this. Such a nice texture. So thin and creamy and full coverage, and nothing comes through, like, creasing wise. Nothing comes through, like, as in you don't get creasing. And then other favorite brand is I can't even speak anymore, I'm talking too much. Bobbi Brown Longwear Cream Shadow in Bone. Any Longwear Cream Shadows by Bobbi Brown are amazing. Drugstore one would have to be definitely the Essence Style Day Longwear Cream Shadows. I think I'm kind of going off track. I went from like bases to cream shadows, but yeah, favorite cream shadows and bases would have to be these two, and then the drugstore alternatives would be the Essence ones. I've got 4 Essence ones. Yeah, they don't crease at all. They're amazing bases, full coverage. Very, very lovely. Now, in terms of eyeshadows, I can't really pick one particular eyeshadow that I love more than any other eyeshadows because I love so many different colours. So I would say my favourite eyeshadow brand. So my favourite eyeshadow brand would have to be Stila. I recently bought like 9 of their eyeshadows, 8 or 9 of their eyeshadows online from Beauty Bay. They are just, I can't even explain how amazing they are. You do one little swipe and you get, like, I literally just softly touched that and I got like a full, you know, coverage swipe. What? They're just, they're god, so amazing. I love this colour here. I'm currently obsessed with cranberry, really, really red, red-based browns. Another amazing one is the Makeup Academy eyeshadow, which is what I'm wearing right now, in shade 28, which is a really, really nice colour. Yeah, I just love those colours. Another one that I love by MAC is, I think it's Antiqued that I love. This one, yes, Antiqued, which is another red-based red. Another one by MAC that I love, which is a perfect transition blending colour. I think this is limited edition, is Indie Spirit. Yes, and favourite drugstore eyeshadow brand would have to be, I'm going to say after buying these Makeup Academy eyeshadows, would be Makeup Academy, NYX, and Jordana. Another drugstore, another high-end favourite eyeshadow is Urban Decay, but yeah. I also love, yeah, NYX eyeshadows are quite fabulous. Milani eyeshadows and Jordana eyeshadows are also my favourite ones. I'll do brushes as well. So my favourite brush brands in general would have to be Sigma. I've got like pretty much most of those brushes that you see are all Sigma ones. Most of my brushes are actually Sigma. Favourite eye brushes are all from Sigma for sure. Performance Eyes Kit, it has pretty much every brush that you could need for basic, or not even basic, quite like, you know, advanced eye makeup. Favourite blending brushes, I have 5 of these, 4 or 5, yeah, I do have 5, are from Coastal Scents. These are called Pro Blending Fluffs. I love that name so much. Number 250, these actually sell for $5 each, and I bought about 3 or 4 when they were on sale for half price. So they're just like the MAC 217s, and they look pretty much the same. Also, if I can find it, as the, there it is, Sigma E25 brush. I only have this in a little mini size, but they look pretty much the same as that. Another favourite brush is the Sigma Pencil E30 brush, perfect for going underneath the lash line. Favourite eyebrow brush that I use every single day is the Sigma Small Angled E65 brush. That's enough of eye brushes. Face brushes for foundation, it would be between the Sigma Foundation F60 brush. I've recently gotten back into using a foundation brush. It would be the Real Techniques Expert Face Brush. I've been using this for a while, but getting a little bit over it now because I've been using it for so long. And the MAC 130 brush. I love this brush because even though it is a stippling brush, and I hate stippling brushes, it's really dense, so it doesn't like bend very easily. And then favourite eye brush for setting powder is the Real Techniques setting brush. That's what I use every single day to set under eye concealer. Whew, that's a lot to say. Okay, favorite face brush, powder brush would have to be the Sigma Large Powder F20 brush or the Bobbi Brown powder brush, but realistically I do prefer this one actually. It's bigger and it's so soft, it's just like straight on your face. I love it, I use it every day. Favorite blush brush is definitely the Bobbi Brown blush brush. I actually use this for contouring now because it has like a nice narrow side here, but then a fat side for blush. So you can use it for blush like that, and then bronzer like that. And then I also love my Sigma Large Angled Contour brush because of the shape, and it's really, really nice and soft, and it diffuses the blush very, very nicely. And for, where is it? There it is. For highlighter, I use the MAC 116 brush. I use the MAC 116 brush because it just, I don't know, it's a nice little shape just to get that little cheekbone-y area. And I think that's pretty much it in terms of favorite face brushes. Yes. I'm not going to do my favorite skincare and stuff because that can be a whole separate video. But yeah, whew. This video is a long video, but a lot of you guys have been saying you love long videos, so hopefully you will appreciate the nice long video and don't get too bored. So I hope you guys enjoyed my first video for 2013. Woo, how exciting! My birthday is on the 7th of January as well, so keep it in mind. It's next Monday, I'm so excited. Also, I now have a PO box, so if you want to send me cute letters and all that cute stuff, just send me a letter. My info for that is down below in the down bar. It always will be. If you ever want to know what the address is, it's always down below, as well as the link to my second YouTube channel, like my vlog channel, my Instagram name, my Twitter, my Tumblr, my Facebook page, all that good stuff down below always. So give it a go, give it a little bit of a check out. Give it a check out? Okay, doesn't make sense. I'm gonna go. But anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next week. Bye, guys.